In this video, I will examine free fall using a microbit. If my experiment is successful, the microbit must display 117 milliseconds. The metal piece falls through an electrician pipe, and after 0.2 meters, it breaks a light beam and the timer in the microbit starts. After a further 0.3 meters drop, another light beam is broken and the timer stops. Let us look at the theoretical fall time. The formula for a free fall with constant acceleration says that the distance s is equal to a half multiplied with the gravity acceleration multiplied with the time squared. Now we change the formula so that t becomes isolated. We set the gravity acceleration to 9.81 and calculate how long it will take to fall the 0.5 meters from the top edge to the lower light beam, and we get 319 milliseconds. In the same way, we can calculate that the upper 0.2 meters will take 202 milliseconds. Therefore, the 0.3 meters between the light rays will take 117 milliseconds. I will now describe how I made the layout. In a 60 centimeter long piece of 16 millimeter electrician pipe, four holes for the LDRs and LEDs are drilled as accurately as possible. Eventually, you can file the area near the holes slightly so that it becomes easier to glue on the components. The two LDRs are best glued with a glue gun. Other glue types can dissolve the surface of the LDR. To mount the pipe, you can use 15 mm plastic or metal clamps. The woodwork looks like this. It is important that everything is at an angle so that the pipe will be completely vertical. The electronics are mounted using brass nails, tin copper wire, solder and soldering iron. With the aid of a plumb line, you can eventually check that the pipe is vertical. Wires are then soldered to the two LDRs. Now it is tempting to arrange two torches or lamps to produce the light beams. I have dealt with that solution very much, but I haven't made it work properly. Instead, I recommend mounting two white LEDs of a type that lights with 14,000 millicandela. Start by gluing on the LED sockets. The holes for the LEDs are so small that the LEDs will not stick into the tube. Therefore, they are not completely fixed in the sockets, so you can twist some tape around them. Now connect the two LEDs to the electronics. the metal piece can be sawn out of an 8mm bolt. Here you see the microbit program. The first loop runs until there is shadow, after which the start time is red. Something similar happens in the next loop, and finally the fall time is calculated. The microbit should be connected as shown here. You also need a 4.5 or 5 volts power supply and a multimeter. When everything is connected, the voltage at P0 and P1 must be set to approximately 2.2 volts by turning the trim pots. Now you can start the experiment.